We're both recording each other. Did you send out an invite to anyone, or you just... Oh, you know it's recording sideways, right? You have to hold it up and down.
Okay.
Yeah, look at how the wording is.
Damn it.
Just turn it. Turn it.
Everyone's all like holding their screen like this now.
Why is Chris Buckle watching here?
C5. Someone wants to see the C5. We're going back to that C5 right now. This is part of the pro section that's being voted on. Guys that may have done it themselves or had a shop done. I don't know, if that's semi-gloss, then that's pretty damn glossy for semi-gloss. Looks like it's a full gloss autoflex. Can you hear me? I don't know if you guys can pick up the sparkle, the heavy flake in this thing, but it's freaking crazy. It's almost similar to like a bass boat finish, but it only pops in the sun. Other than that, the car looks just like a deep purple. Someone's asking about the color or the name of this color. Actually, I think the owner of the car is right here. Hey, you guys are live right now on Dip Your Car. Someone's asking about what color you guys are, the name of the color for that.
Fully custom.
Polestar purple with like some juices.
Okay. Hopefully that answers your question. Here's a car that I helped Matt Chaheen mask up, and I was there for a couple nights helping him clean it up and get it back together and whatnot. It's a jade pearl, some stenciling. There's Detroit, and we have the road. A long 20-hour drive. All the way to DipCon 2016. And then if you watch in certain lighting, the stenciling actually disappears. It almost is ghosted in. And then all of a sudden it pops up. This is actually done for Matt's wife in memory, or not memory, but because her dad means a lot to her. So she has that little custom little touch to it. Hey, no problem, Jason. I drove all the way in from Michigan, so I know how it's a long-ass drive. It was very exhausting, and we were worried about that whole hurricane situation, but we made it through. We actually bypassed it. The hurricane passed over us, and we had like 3 speckles of water, and that's it. Maybe a 40-mile-an-hour wind for about a half hour, and we were good. This guy, he was in such a hurry to get here. He didn't care if anyone was in his way. He just kept on go. I'm going to try to make this as interactive as possible for anyone that's watching this right now. As you can see, we got food that's provided to us. I don't know if they're charging or if it's free, or we're going to Fonzie's checkbook. They're charging. But is it good?
It's not bad, yeah.
Okay. Yeah, I was there. I recorded the guy cooking it, so I'm going to try to make a video on my phone with the features it's got. There's a Veloster. White with obviously the blood splatter pattern going on. Actually, it's one of the most realistic ones I've seen. It actually looks like literally he pulled a Mustang and hit a crowd or something. And then we got Eric's Mustang here. He had to do some final touches on it, a little detailing on it last night. He brought it out with it. He's in the competition for the do-it-yourself section. Yeah, like the headlights that you're mentioning, Jason, it looks like, yeah, he dipped over, and then obviously he needed the light, so he peeled away a little bit. So it kind of completes the look, and then he still has the functionality without making it super obnoxious with just a headlight that pops up out of nowhere. Hey, Eric. Patrick says hi.
Hi, Patrick.
Patrick,
Cornelia?
Yep.
Yeah, what's up, man?
He's like, it's like I'm there. And in case you are wondering what I look like, here's me. You can see my username that's streaming this. I'm usually on the technical side of answering questions and posting and stuff, so. The V-dub done in auto gloss, or auto flex, I'm sorry. Looks like he got it laid out nicely. Looks like it might be Tahitian or something. And this, believe it or not, which actually it blew my mind last night when I met this guy. It's Rob Kitt's WRX or STI. He actually auto flexed the blue on this car. This is not the original color. The original color is actually this metallic black. And he had me fooled. I thought he actually did the black parts, but he actually reverse psychology me and almost recreated the OEM Rally Blue for the Subarus, which in person, for someone that did not have a full booth and had the patience to do this on his own in his garage, I believe he told me, it came out pretty darn good for right out of the gun. I'm going to walk over here. We're going to see the display that Dip Your Car actually has going on. They have a raffle that they're doing here, giving away wheels, some spray guns, some detail kits, some pearl packs. And then we've actually got Fonzie. I'm walking over to Fonzie right now. I'm going to walk up. Get Fonzie to say hi, everyone. You're live right now on Dip Your Car's Facebook page. Yeah. What hurricane are we talking about again? Yeah, that's what I thought. There's Fonzie himself. It was nice shaking his hand, actually meeting the guy that made this all possible in person.
How you doing?
We got Bennett. I probably talked to him once or twice on the phone. Got a couple other guys, I believe, are employees. Who's everyone in here? Gabe, I've talked to you, I think, once in the past. Jared, I've talked to you before. The what?
Graphics and whatnot.
Yep. You got little displays and stuff that they can sell here. Got various raffles going on. We got wheels. We got quite a few people that are interested in the wheels. They've got a drone that they're raffling off. Pretty effective, affordable spray gun for the guys that want to do the professional line stuff. They got gift cards, detail kits. And then here's a few of the cars that you guys may have seen videos of Fonzie doing. And when I say this, for coming right out of the gun, for a guy that does not have a background in painting, I'm very, very impressed. And this car, if you did not know, you would actually think that this was vinyl wrapped. I don't know if you guys can pick it up, but this stuff is laid out like glass. No corrective stuff, obviously, because this is, I believe, Plasti-Dip. This right here, I had a little discussion with Fonzie. It's may have been hinted a few times now. He's got a new few products that he's going to be releasing. He's still doing testing. Fonzie's big on his testing, and I bet everyone can appreciate that, because obviously we don't want to have issues with any of our installations. But if you guys want to recreate that in any other product, there's all your mixtures and stuff. This is something that came out of nowhere. London flew in from Hawaii yesterday afternoon. And as you can see, the M3 is no longer just the factory. The phone I'm using is the Moto X Pure on T-Mobile. And T-Mobile service is actually pretty solid down here, so I'm probably picking up a pretty good signal. I've dropped a call here or there, but for the most part, yeah, I'm actually very impressed with this phone for video quality and consistency. So if you guys are looking for a new phone, I highly recommend it. It is a year and a half old phone, but it still holds its own against some of the newer stuff that is coming out. Little detail stenciling. That is not a decal on there. That is actually stenciling that was done. I don't know if you guys can pick that up, but I watched London peel these off, and he was very, very meticulous about how accurately he pulled it off. I'm going to see if I can find London for you guys, if you guys want to see what a Hawaiian guy looks like. And then Fonzie's personal vehicle, auto-flexed RS7. It's kind of hard to pick it up because I'm actually in a shadowy area, so I'm going to try to pick up the shift on this, but this thing is crazy. And for being straight out of the gun, very, very, very clean. There's maybe one or two pieces of dirt in this thing, but you really got to be looking for them. I tried, and I have a painting background, and he had me fooled. It still cannot wrap my head around the background that Fonzie has and what he's able to pull off with a removable product. It's just crazy. Yeah, I'm going to keep going live here probably for another 5 minutes or so, guys. And let this upload. I believe it does uploads after you get done recording live. And maybe jump back on here shortly. We got Honest Wash. Looks like they have a display of different products that they deem compatible for using for maintaining dip and stuff like that. Is this stuff that's going to be possibly offered by Dip Your Car, or is this something you guys are going above and beyond and saying, hey, we have a product that will work, but we're not affiliated in any way?
Maybe offered by Dip Your Car.
Okay. This is live, just in case you're wondering why I'm... Okay, I didn't know if you... Just making sure if you say anything that maybe you're not supposed to, but I appreciate your time. And we have a display here by TSS, or the spray source, if you guys are in the higher end of install. We've got different air dryers, different masking stuff, different equipment, protective stuff, the different guns that they're bring it onto the market for the dipper guys and possibly even painter guys, which is my background, so I'm interested in the specs and stuff. And then we have Jesse K here.
What's up?
He actually flew in. There was a...
How'd you came in the hurricane?
Yeah, he actually got flown in through the hurricane. So it was a little bit of a surprise for Fonzie because he thought he wasn't making it in. So that was kind of cool. And if anyone wants to shout out your names or whatever, this is all live on Dip Your Car's Facebook. So anyone's got... This guy's name is Kevin, but it's not. So if you have any complaints, just have email them to Kevin. What is it?
I won Dip of the Year.
He won Dip of the Year. From Dip Tex. As Chicago Dip. And then you are strictly TSS, right?
Yeah.
Okay. And we have Luke. It looks like that's what his name tag is, or that's the one they gave him this morning. There's Eric again. And then we got Boston. They have a small display here displaying some of the possibilities with their wheels. Up close and personal, these are look like some very quality pieces. They start out at 19-inch wheels and go up from there. I actually entered into the raffle myself for my own vehicle, a 2016 Fusion. But I am a little bit limited on these bolt pattern unless I get into the forged ones, which my pocketbook cannot not allow. But it is nice to know that they do make wheels in my size. And this is a S8 that they have with a set of their wheels. Now we're going to walk over to, looks like an ice cream stand just popped up. This was not here about 5 minutes ago, and because it's 90 degrees plus, it's definitely going to be refreshing to have some of that later on. I'm going to walk over to this section over here. These are maybe some overflow cars, and then also people that have come from around the area that heard about DipCon. So these are a lot of local guys. And there's Fonzie's S8. Got a Mustang down here. Looks like pretty cleanly done. Got a Porsche with a lot of black accents that were added onto it. It looks like it's OEM silver. And for the Veloster people, in case there's a group of you guys watching this or not, or gonna be watching it, and Melissa, which is back at Michigan, a car that I did personally in a, Nebula Purple and Martian Violet. Told her that a few of her possible friends off her other groups are going to be here, so this is for her.
We also got a car show going on over here.
Nice, cleanly done.
DIY car show.
For doing it themselves, very, very nice work. This one, actually, I don't know if you can pick it up. It is a white with a gold pearl, which picks up in the sun. And this looks like a auto flex job that was done. It mentions Tampa on there. I'm guessing it is a car from Tampa that drove in. So, yeah. Here's a Volkswagen Golf. Someone came up in here. Looks like it's nicely set up. I don't think this thing is dipped or anything like that, but another car enthusiast is always welcome.
How's it going? How's it going, man?
What's up? Want to say hi? You're live.
We're live.
That's it?
That's it. That's all I got to say.
Wow.
Me and Chris.
Titletown Dips out of Wisconsin. They made it in. Yeah, Chris Buckle, a lot of you guys
drove 30 hours.
Yeah, they drove 30. I drove 20. My back is still killing. So, yeah, it's nice to see a lot of guys actually long distance-wise, they still made it in. I see a couple other cars peeking in here. Actually, I missed this one. I didn't see this one. Got a white 350Z. Looks like they've got like a blaze pink on here, or a very vivid pink little accent, so I'm gonna make the assumption that this is a female's car. And yeah, that's definitely a nice little touch. Got a G8 that looks like someone did it themselves, or maybe had someone do it that happens to be dipped. Looks very similar to my Sentra. This is maybe like a sapphire blue. My Sentra's done in a Martian blue, a little bit lighter pigment load, so, but very similar. It might even actually be the same color. Other than that, got a couple more cars here, and I'm gonna go catch up with a few people and then maybe jump back on if things change around here with more cars showing up or people start shifting around. We've got a Challenger here. They might not have been able to find a Purple Plum Crazy one, and they were able to do it on their own and drive around in a Plum Crazy Challenger. And for all I know, this might be a yellow car or a black car. Got a nice clean Genesis. Like, he's a car enthusiast. He may have done a spot or two on his car. Very nicely done. It looks like we have a like a graphite gray color Camaro here. Again, I don't know what original color this thing is, so it's interesting to see what's possible with this stuff and fool people. Maybe they got a really good deal on a purple one and they don't really like purple. Well, they were able to change the color, drive it around like that, turn it in back on lease if it's a lease, and no harm, no foul. But as of right now, people are still rolling in here, so it's still early on in the event. We're going to be here till about 4 p.m. Eastern time, so I'm anticipating there's going to be a few more people. But appreciate you guys watching. If anything else changes, you guys want to link to this thing, stay tuned. I will try to log back in. All right, see you later.